Trust your first impression. What do you see?
I'm in a house.
I'm in a house. Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
There's like candles on the wall, like or like gas lights.
Mm-hmm.
And the walls have like dark wood trim.
Mm-hmm.
But they're light.
And the walls are light, but they have the dark trims.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
There's a staircase. Wood staircase.
Mm-hmm.
It feels like Victorian.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So I want you to focus on yourself. Look down and see if you can see your feet.
Mm-hmm.
What do you see?
Shoes.
Mm-hmm.
Black.
Black. Are these male or female shoes?
Female.
Mm-hmm. So now that you see your shoes, what else are you wearing?
I'm wearing a dress with like a big bustle.
Mm-hmm.
My butt looks big.
Mm-hmm. What color is this?
It's cream, like, but it's like checkered, like gingham with like brown, dark brown gingham.
Mm-hmm. What else are you wearing?
It has long sleeves with buttons.
Anything on your head?
I'm wearing my hair up.
Mm-hmm. What color is it?
Dark brown.
How old do you feel there?
Like late 20s, maybe.
Mm-hmm. Are you carrying anything in this house?
No.
Let's find out what you're doing there. I want you to take me through the scene and see what's there.
I feel alone, but I feel like I'm up, like upper class, like.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel kind of bored.
Yes. What do you feel you do there?
I feel like I'm just there and I'm just kind of kept.
Mm-hmm. Who keeps you?
I'm living with my family. I'm not married. I feel like I'm like my parents live there. But I feel like my father's there too, and he's kind of like domineering.
Yes.
And wants me to marry somebody that's, like, worthy or has made something of himself. And mm-hmm. I'm there and I'm kind of just bored. Like, don't care, really.
Mm-hmm. So let's see what it is that you do during the day. What kind of activities do you do?
Like sewing or something.
Mm-hmm.
Just sitting in a room.
Are you by yourself or is there someone with you?
There's somebody with, I think it's my mother.
Mm-hmm.
And we're just sitting there kind of doing this like sewing thing.
Mm-hmm.
Making small talk.
Yes.
It feels kind of shallow.
Mm-hmm. As you look at your mother, take a look at your eyes. Her eyes.
Mm-hmm.
And see if you recognize your mother from anybody in the life of Jackie. Does she seem familiar to you?
No.
Okay. So let's close that scene now. And now let's open that scene to another important event in your life. But something is happening. Where are you?
Getting married.
So check in with your feelings and see how you feel about this event.
Indifferent.
Tell me who you're marrying.
He does something with money.
That's what he does for a living? And is this marriage something that was arranged?
It was, like, encouraged. And I went along with it.
So you gave it the consent to do it? But right now?
I just, feel like I'm not really attracted to him, but I wanted to make my family happy. More specifically, my dad.
Is this man your age or is he older?
He's a little older, but close.
Very good. So let's see what happens. What happens next? What's going on?
Everyone's just, we're outside and everyone's celebrating. And I feel like I should be more excited.
How are you reacting?
Like I'm faking it.
So you're not really showing what you feel to anybody. I want you to connect with those around you. Do they know that you're not happy?
Some do.
How does it feel to be in that position where you're not being authentic?
Feels sad. But I feel like I don't have any other choice.
All right. Let's move now, close that scene, move ahead to another important scene in that same life. Something important is happening. Where are you?
In the kitchen.
What are you doing there?
I feel like I'm trying to make something. But I don't really know how.
What are you trying to make?
Bread.
Is there anybody else there with you? Take a look around.
There's like a servant or something. I feel like I'm trying to prove that I can do something.
Is it working?
No.
So what happens with the bread?
It turns out okay, but it's a mess when I'm making it. I feel like I give it to my husband and he just like kind of laughs at me.
How do you feel about the bread? Do you feel proud of yourself?
I did until he laughed at me.
And then how did it make you feel?
Stupid.
Did he say anything or did you just react to him?
He laughed at it. Like, what are you doing?
Very good. So let's continue and see what happens next. What are you feeling?
Lonely and unfulfilled. Mm-hmm.
How do you spend your days now as a married woman?
Alone. Mm-hmm. I feel like he's always working, but I kind of don't mind because I don't really like him.
Good. Well, let's close that scene now. Let's move ahead. Another significant event in your life. What's happening?
My mother died.
Tell me more.
I feel like she's not even that old.
Tell me how you're feeling. Go deep into your emotions.
My heart aches.
Tell me what you're feeling and why.
I feel like she was like the only person who understood how unhappy and like unfulfilled the life was, because she led the same life.
You were both the same.
Now I feel really alone.
And let's move on now. Close that scene. Pick another significant event in your lifetime. Where are you? What's happening?
I think he's sick, my husband.
What do you experience there?
He's in a bed. And there's a doctor.
Let's listen in and see what he says.
It's like some kind of pneumonia or something. I think he's probably gonna die.
How are you feeling?
Been different.
So let's move ahead until it happens. Take me with you. What's going on?
He died in his bed.
So let's see what happens to you now. I want you to fast forward to another event in your life. What's significant that shows how your life is now? Where are you?
I feel like I'm at some kind of like rally or gathering or something mm-hmm. with a bunch of other women.
Mm-hmm. What are you doing there?
Speaking out.
Mm-hmm. What are you speaking out for?
Women.
Mm-hmm. So I want you to think now what year it is.
It's like early 1900s, mm-hmm. teens maybe.
Okay, I'm going to snap my finger, and when I do, the date will just appear in your mind.
1919.
Mm-hmm. And where are you?
London.
Mm-hmm. So let's see what happens, what this rally is all about.
Voting.
Mm-hmm. How does it make you feel to be in this place?
Alive.
Ah. Mm-hmm. Go deep inside and tell me what emotions are bubbling up.
Love.
Very good. Where are you getting this love from?
Myself.
Wonderful. Perfect. So let's close that scene now. Let's move forward. Tell me where you are.
I'm at some kind of gathering mm-hmm. in somebody's house with some other women. And I feel very close with them.
Mm-hmm. What's the gathering about?
Nothing really in particular. Mm-hmm. We're just spending time together, but we've been to, like, a different... We met through this cause.
Mm-hmm.
We're bonded that way.
Wonderful. How do you feel when you're with these women?
Happy, mm-hmm. fulfilled.
Look around the room and see if you recognize any of the women in that room as being part of Jackie's life.
Anne.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
I think Lisa's there too.
Mm-hmm. And who are they to you in that life?
They're like fellow women.
Mm-hmm.
Fighting for the same thing.
Fighting for the same thing. Very mm-hmm. good. Very good. So now let's close that scene and let's go. You're much older now. Much older. And tell me what's going on.
I'm in my same house.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't have any, like, servants. I live there alone now.
Yes. How old do you feel?
80.
Mm-hmm. What are you doing there in your days?
I just read and just spend time with myself and with my friends, and it's peaceful.
Mm-hmm.
It feels like my space.
Yes, yes. So do you feel that you're at peace mm-hmm. at this moment? Good. So now let's advance to the last day of your life. Tell me where you are.
In my bed.
Mm-hmm. What's happening with you?
Just old. Mm-hmm. Shutting down.
So before you transition out of that body, I want you to tell me, what thoughts are you thinking about your life?
God, I wish I would have stood up for myself sooner.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel now?
I feel happy with what I accomplished.
Mm-hmm.
Like maybe other women can figure it out sooner.
Mm-hmm. As you look back at your life, seeing how you married, can you see any benefits to having had your life work out that way?
Yeah, I wouldn't have, like, craved the freedom
mm-hmm.
without feeling like I was in such a prison.
Mm-hmm. Would you have been financially settled?
No.
Mm-hmm. So can you see the benefits of having experienced what you did?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Good. As you look at your life with that perspective, how do you see your life now?
Accomplished.
Mm-hmm. Good. So take your last breath in that life and transition over, leave that body behind, and tell me what happens. Where do you go?
Tunnel.
Mm-hmm. A tunnel. Tell me where that tunnel leads. Mm-hmm. So as you're going towards the light, I want you to think back at that life that you lived. What was the purpose of living that life? What did you want to learn from it? What was the purpose of it?
I learned how to listen to myself and that it's okay.
Mm-hmm. To listen to yourself and it's okay. Did you learn any lessons from it? Okay.
Not to sacrifice.
Not to sacrifice.
I learned what it feels like to love what you do.
Love what you do. Very good. So let's continue to that white light and see what happens after you reach it. Where do you go? Do you see anybody or anything there?
Mm-hmm.
And what do you see?
There's people there greeting me, but I can't see their faces.
Mm-hmm. What do they seem like? Are they dressed any particular way?
Mm-hmm.
How are they dressed?
They're wearing brown robes.
Brown robes.
With hoods.
Mm-hmm. How many are there?
4.
Mm-hmm. Are they male or female?
Both.
Both. Okay. So let's see who these people are. As you approach them, what do you get from them?
One of them feels like an older man.
Mm-hmm.
Wise.
Mm-hmm. Very wise.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. What about the others?
It's just like there's a nurturing,
mm-hmm.
like almost like a grandmother-y type feeling.
Uh-huh. From all of them?
No, from the second one.
The second one, okay.
Mm-hmm.
What about the others?
They feel younger.
Younger? Mm-hmm.
Maybe my age or a little bit older.
Mm-hmm. So connect with these four and find out what they're doing there.
They're welcoming me.
Mm-hmm. Connect with them mind to mind and see what they say.
We're so proud of you.
What else?
I love you.
How do you know these?
They're my guide.
Mm-hmm. So let's see what happens next with your guides. Where do they take you?
To my group.
To your group. Mm-hmm. Who are these? Look around you.
Mm-hmm.
Where are you?
It's like I'm kind of like floating in space.
Mm-hmm. Is your group with you?
I'm standing on the outside.
Mm-hmm.
Waiting to go in.
Mm-hmm. And where is it that you're going into?
Feels like a bubble.
Hmm.
Room. Bubble room.
A bubble room. Mm-hmm. You're in the bubble room? Or are you going into it?
Going in.
Okay. How do you get inside this bubble room?
You just float into it.
Mm-hmm. So float into it and see what happens next.
The rune's coming up to me.
Mm-hmm.
They want to know, like, what happened, and they're excited.
Mm-hmm. How many do you see?
Six.
Six. Do they have any type of shape or form?
Or just balls of light.
Balls of light. Mm-hmm. And these are your group?
Mm-hmm.
How do you feel when you see them?
Home.
Mm. Very good. So what happens in this bubble room?
Tell stories.
What stories are you telling?
About where we've been and what we've done.
Mm-hmm. Have they been with you before? Mm-hmm. Were they with you in that last life? As this woman?
Some.
Mm-hmm. Were any of these in your life as difficult people?
No.
No. Okay. These are friends? Mm-hmm. Very good. Let's see what happens after the bubble room. Where do you go to next?
I'm going with the old man.
Mm-hmm. Look around you and see what it looks like where you are.
Feels like space.
Mm, good. Where is he taking you?
To a room.
Mm-hmm. Tell me when you get there.
Okay.
What does this room look like?
School.
School. Mm-hmm. Are you by yourself or are there others there?
By myself.
Mm-hmm. So what is the subject matter that you're learning in this school?
Life.
Who's teaching it?
Everyone.
Everyone. How do you learn in this school?
Experience.
Mm-hmm. Is there something that you want to learn in particular while you're there?
How to love.
How to love. So how is it that you're going to learn how to love? What experience are you looking for?
Pain.
Pain?
What being kind? Hurt.
Oh, being hurt. Mm-hmm. How would that teach you to love?
Have compassion.
Mm-hmm. How do you plan to learn this?
People hurt me.
Mm-hmm. So let's go to see who's going to go with you. Who's going to go on your journey? What do you see?
Luke.
Mm-hmm. What is his agreement to do in this lifetime, in this next one? What's your agreement?
Betrayal.
Betrayal. Mm-hmm. Who came up with that plan?
We both did.
Both did. Mm-hmm. How do you feel about Luke in that classroom?
I'm sad that...
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
I like him.
Mm-hmm. But he's agreed to betray you?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. For this experience that you want?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Does that make you sad?
A little, but I know mm-hmm. it'll be okay.
So what do you say to each other before you part?
It's for a good reason.
Mm-hmm. Is there anybody else in the room that's going to come with you to help you learn?
Anne.
Mm-hmm. And what's your agreement with Anne?
She guides me.
Mm-hmm. How is she going to guide you in this life?
Perspective.
Does she know there'll be a betrayal?
She senses it. But she knows that it has to happen.
Good. Take a look around and see if there's anybody else there that's going to help you with this life to fulfill what you need to learn.
No.
Good. Very good. So now let's leave that scene and now let's go to the scene where you pick your parents. You pick the lifetime. Where are you?
I'm with the old man.
With the old man. Where are you?
Watching a movie. Looks like a movie.
What's in this movie?
Little boy on a tricycle.
Who is that little boy?
It's my dad.
What else do you see? How do you feel when you see that little boy?
Love.
What else do you see in that movie?
I know it's my mom. I see her being hit.
What's happening with her? She's being hit? Who's hitting her?
Her dad.
How do you feel when you see that?
Sad.
Why are you seeing these two on the screen?
Making a choice.
Talk to your guide and see what choice it is that you're making.
Picking up.
Have you seen others besides these two? Mm-hmm. And what attracted you to these two?
They're so different.
How will that help you?
Let's see both sides of things. Emotion and logic.
Is that one of the lessons you want to learn?
To understand.
Understand the differences. Very good. Is there anything else that your guide teaches you?
Love.
Mm-hmm. How does he teach you this love?
He shows it to me. Unconditional.
Are you supposed to be learning this?
Yes.
How will you use this love in a lifetime of Jackie?
Show others.
What else do you learn before you are born?
Boundaries.
What kind of boundaries do you need to keep?
Knowing when.
What is it?
Knowing when to protect myself.
Knowing when to protect yourself. Good. So let me ask you if you have selected any particular time astrologically to be born, to become the person that you are.
Yeah.
How do you select that?
You know, when the certain transits are going to happen and the energy.
So how do you know it's going to work out, being that you can't control your parents' passion for each other? And when you're conceived, do you have anything to do with that?
No. It just is. You just don't worry about it.
You don't worry about it. You just know that it's going to line up. Okay, very good. Do you determine the date and the time that you arrive? Very good. Is there anything else that you do before you need to be born into the life of Jackie?
I just get lots of love.
Lots of love. You do give them lots of love?
I get it from my group.
From your group. Very good. How big is this group?
Seven.
Okay, very good. So I'd like you to leave that scene, close that scene behind you. Let's go drifting away from that scene. Thank you very much for being here today. Why did you show Jackie that lifetime of that Victorian woman?
She needs to know that she can do what she wants to do.
What's holding her back now?
Fear.
Fear. Where is this fear coming from?
Mm-hmm. past.
Mm-hmm. The past. Is it the past in this life or other lives?
Other lives.
Other lives. Are there any lives that are affecting her today that we need to work on today and see?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What life is that that you'd like to show her?
Just
allow yourself to drift and float to that lifetime. Drifting and floating. Be there now. Where are you?
Germany.
Germany. Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
Jewish.
Mm-hmm. What year is this?
37.
1937?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And where are you? What country?
Germany.
Germany. Okay. What's happening?
Starving.
Starving. Why are you starving?
Mm.
Look around you. Where are you? Are you indoors or outdoors?
Indoors.
Indoors. Mm-hmm. Are you alone or others with you?
Others.
Mm-hmm. So tell me where you are.
Concentration camp.
Mm-hmm. Do you know the name of it?
Auschwitz.
Mm-hmm. Auschwitz. How old are you?
13.
13. And what's your name?
Helen.
Helen. Helen, are you by yourself or is your family with you?
My mom's with me.
Mm-hmm. What's going on, Helen?
Starving.
Starving. Is everyone starving with you?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So check me through and see what happens. What happens next, Helen?
We're all dying.
Mm-hmm. We're all dying.
Just wasting away.
Wasting away.
So dark.
Mm-hmm.
Cold.
Dark and cold.
People die every day.
How many people are in the place where you are now?
I'm in a room with two others, but there's so many of us.
Mm-hmm. What are you thinking about when you're in this place, Helen?
I'll never see my family again.
Mm-hmm. How does that make you feel?
Lost.
Mm-hmm.
Afraid.
Afraid. So tell me what happens. I want you to go to a significant time in that lifetime.
I'm taking my mom away.
You're taking your mom away? Mm-hmm.
She's screaming.
Who's taking her?
Guards.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
and then I'm never going to see her.
I want you to follow that feeling in your body. Where do you feel it?
My heart. Mm-hmm. My stomach.
Mm-hmm. Your stomach. What happens in your stomach?
It's balled up, clenched up.
Mm-hmm. Balled up. So, Helen, let's see what happens next. What happens to you?
I'm suffocating.
Mm-hmm. You're suffocating. Where are you?
In my room.
In your room. Mm-hmm. How are you suffocating?
Pillow.
A pillow. Who's suffocating you?
Me.
You're just putting it over your head.
Mm-hmm.
What is the significance of this event? Why are you doing this?
I'm trying to kill myself.
Mm-hmm. So let's see what happens. What happens after this?
I'm still there.
Mm-hmm. Wasn't very successful.
No.
Mm-hmm. How does that make you feel?
Worse.
Mm-hmm. Let's move ahead now, Helen. See what happens. Another significant event. It's sunny. Mm-hmm.
I'm outside.
Mm-hmm. I'm outside. How's the weather?
Beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Who's outside with you?
Others.
Mm-hmm.
I'm working.
What are you doing?
Digging something.
Mm-hmm. What's in your hands?
Shovel.
A shovel. What are you digging?
Ditch.
Mm-hmm. Do you know why?
Bodies.
Bodies. Tell me more.
Hiding bodies.
Hiding bodies? Who's hiding them?
People in charge?
Do you see the bodies?
No.
You just know it?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. How does that make you feel, digging these ditches?
Sick.
How old are you now, Helen?
18.
Mm-hmm. Are they feeding you?
Little.
Mm-hmm. So let's close that scene. Let's move to another significant scene in that lifetime. What's going on?
Made it out.
How did you make it out?
They let us go.
So where are you?
I'm leaving.
What is it?
I'm leaving.
You're leaving.
Mm-hmm. Moving the gates.
The gates are open. Mm-hmm. How do you feel?
Lost.
Tell me more.
I just have no one and nothing. I don't know who's alive and who's not. Overwhelmed.
Mm-hmm. So let's see where you go. I want you to move forward in that lifetime to see what happens and where you go. Where do you end up?
I live alone.
Mm-hmm. You're alone?
Mm-hmm.
Where are you?
A little house.
A little house. Go deep inside in you and see what emotions you're feeling in this place.
Scared.
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
This could, it could take it away from me.
Mm-hmm.
Whenever they want.
Whose house is this?
It's mine.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't trust anything.
Mm-hmm. They've taken away everything of yours before, haven't they?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So even though you're in that house peacefully, you're still living in fear.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's not a good way to be, Helen.
Mm-mm.
Let's move forward and let's see what happens. Where are you? Still there. How old do you feel?
12.
Mm-hmm. Check in with your feelings and tell me how you're feeling now. Are you still afraid?
I'm always afraid.
You're always afraid. Mm-hmm. Let's now move to the last day of your life, Helen. Tell me where you are.
On the street.
On the street. What are you doing on the street?
Collapsed.
Is it because of an illness or did you live on the street?
Illness.
Mm-hmm. So, before you transition out of that body, Helen, I want you to see yourself still breathing. And tell me what's going through your mind.
I'm glad to go.
Mm-hmm.
Life was torture.
Mm-hmm. But Helen, before you go, I want to help you go a little lighter. Would you allow me to help you?
Mm-hmm.
You've been held down for a long time with a lot of pain and anguish, haven't you?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Would you allow me to relieve some of that from you?
Mm-hmm.
Very good. I'm going to put my hand on your chest. And I want you to give me all of those feelings of losing your family, starving, having that insecurity of not knowing if you're going to live the next day. the insecurity of not knowing if you're going to have a home. All of that insecurity of not knowing, of feeling lost, feeling lonely, give it all to me. Pull that from every cell of your body, Helen. Don't leave anything in. And tell me when I have it all. Give it all to me. Let's take that and give it up to the universe. Now, Helen, as you're lying there, collapsed on the ground now, without all of that horrible feeling that was weighing you down, what would you like to fill it with so you can leave light as a feather? What would you like to replace all of those feelings with?
Safety.
Let's put that in. Put lots of safety in there. Feel yourself totally safe, totally secure, knowing that all is well at all times. And I'm going to touch your forehead and seal that in there. What else would you like to feel, Helen?
Peace.
Let's put lots of peace in there. Allow yourself to feel that peace soaking in and sealing it. What else?
Love.
Let's put lots of love. Lots of love in there. Allow it to fill all of your essence. Feel the divine light of love coming in and seal it. How do you feel now, Helen?
Lighter.
Very good. Helen, can you forgive all of those people that betrayed you and your family? Knowing that they were just doing their job. They didn't know any better. Can you understand?
Yeah.
This was something that they were just following orders.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Release that. Give it to me. Release all of that. We don't need that anymore. Can you forgive yourself for living a life of fear all of those years?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So take all of that fear away. I want you to breathe it in, Helen. Breathe it in. And now, take your last breath. And tell me where you go.
In the tunnel.
Mm-hmm. Very good. And tell me what happens in the tunnel after you leave. Who do you see?
The old man.
The old man. What does he tell you?
He hugs
me. Mm, he hugs me. Mm-hmm. What else?
You made it.
You made it. What was the lesson of that lifetime?
Forgiveness.
Forgiveness. And do you feel that you have forgiven now?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Very good. What lessons do you feel that you learned that could help Jackie in this lifetime?
Forgiveness.
Mm-hmm. And I'd like for you to look at Jackie and see, what is it that you're affecting her with from that lifetime? What influence do you have on her, positive and negative?
She survives.
Mm-hmm. She survives. She always feels that she has to eat quickly. Is that because of your lifetime?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Let's disconnect that from her, please. She doesn't need that anymore. Cut the cord to that life so that she doesn't feel like she's starving. And does that lifetime have anything to do with her tummy?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Tell her what it is.
She feels like she needs to hold on to everything.
Mm-hmm. And is it true that she needs to hold on to everything?
No.
All right. So let's allow that to be cut also, knowing that she doesn't need to hold on to anybody, anything any longer, because it's not going to be taken away from her. Whatever she has, she'll be able to get it again. Is there anything else that Jackie needs to learn from that lifetime?
Not to live in fear.
Not to live in fear. Very good. So let's disconnect now that life from Jackie's. She doesn't need those lessons anymore. And let me speak with the higher self. Do you feel that she's gotten the information she needs from that lifetime?
Yes.
Okay. Now she knows why she eats quickly, why she's holding all of that weight in her belly. Is that true?
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Very good. May I continue with the questions now?
Yes.
Thank you. What should she do with her life? She wants to know what she's supposed to be doing and why she's here now.
Help people.
Help people. Mm-hmm. In what way?
Show them love.
Show them love. Mm-hmm. Is she doing that now?
Yes.
Very good. What is she supposed to be doing as far as spiritual work is concerned?
Mentoring.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. This program that she's been learning, is this one that she should be working with?
That's a start.
That's a start. Okay. What about things like spiritual healing work?
Yes.
What kind would you recommend? She says she's very good with astrology. She's very interested.
Mm-hmm.
Is that something that would be beneficial?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But she feels that she's not good enough.
Just to practice.
Okay. So she just needs to practice and then she'll be good at it.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Anything else in that?
She needs to open herself up.
Mm-hmm. Emotionally?
No, she's open emotionally.
Mm-hmm. So what way should she open herself?
Her mind.
Her mind. Can we begin working with that today?
Yes.
All right. So go ahead and start opening her mind. Are any mentors coming her way?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So when she starts learning new things?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Anything specific that she should be studying?
Astrology, but
mm-hmm.
There's more.
Okay, so if I could ask on her behalf to send her all of the different indications so that she can easily go on that path. Unless you want to tell her now.
She'll find out.
Thank you. She says that when she was a child, she had a few episodes that she can remember of being profoundly lonely and feeling homesick. But she was surrounded by her family and parents. Where did this come from?
She missed her guide.
Okay. That's her family.
Mm-hmm.
the old man. Mm-hmm. Does he have a name?
Herman.
Herman. Mm-hmm. Did he guide her here today?
Yeah.
Okay, good. What did he want her to learn from? What did he want her to learn from this situation, this experience?
She already has all the answers.
Okay, good. She also said that she has had many dreams that feel real. Hmm. Tsunamis, all these other things. Hmm. What was the purpose of having those dreams?
To wake her up.
Hmm. Is she awake now?
She's getting there.
Okay. What about the recurring nightmares about plane crashes? Hmm. What's that all about?
Past life.
A past life. Did you want to show her that past life?
She doesn't need it.
Okay. Can we disconnect that past life from her?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What was it supposed to be showing her anyway? Was there a fear there that she was connecting with?
Yeah.
All right. Would you disconnect that life? Cut that cord to that life now?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Thank you. She says she feels like she sabotages herself a lot, almost afraid to experience success and joy. Is this coming from the life of Helen?
Yeah.
Okay. So we don't need to have that anymore. She can be successful and not worry about losing it?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Good. She also says she has a very low self-worth related to her body image. And she has a hard time moving past this. How can we heal this? She feels so frustrated with herself. Did she choose this body?
Yes.
And for what purpose?
To see her worth.
To see her worth. So when she chose her body, she felt that this was the perfect body for her?
Yeah.
Tummy and all?
It would force her to look beyond the physical.
Ah. So when you have something that you don't like about your body, it makes you look beyond.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Is that something that's typical for most people?
Yes.
Okay, good. So now that she knows that, can she understand why she chose that?
Yeah.
It's just a reminder.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Can you tell her why she keeps seeing the number fives? What are you telling her?
Get ready.
Is there something happening?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, can you give her a hint?
She's about to really change.
About to change?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Is she moving?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is it where she wants to move?
Yes.
Okay. How about relationships?
Hmm.
Is that changing?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What about her job?
Yes. Okay. Everything.
Everything. So her life is totally changing after this.
Mm-hmm.
When do you think this is going to happen?
Soon.
Soon. Okay. Good. So who's orchestrating this change?
She is.
She is. Okay. So whatever she has been thinking about is now going to take place
mm-hmm.
in a whole big way.
Yeah.
Good. Mm. Good. What about the issue about the election? She has so much uncertainty and fear about that. What would you like to tell her? She wants to be able to stay grounded.
Keep doing what she's doing.
Mm-hmm.
Stay away from the...
Stay away from where?
Stay away from the news.
Stay away from the news?
Like the mainstream news.
Mm-hmm.
take it in bits and pieces if she has to.
Mm-hmm. What happens when you're looking at this mainstream news?
You become afraid.
You become afraid?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So just turn off the news. Don't listen to it. Don't worry about it.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Just love. Just be love and don't be afraid.
Be love and don't be afraid. Good, good. She says that she wants to open a private therapy practice. But mm-hmm. She stopped herself because of fears about benefits. Are there any other things that are blocking her?
It's from the life with Helen.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
Feeling like it'll all be taken away.
Right. So is there anything to worry about?
No.
So go ahead and open that practice?
Yeah.
Very good. When should she do that?
As soon as possible.
Mm-hmm. Is she going to be doing that in St. Louis?
Yes.
Okay. So obviously she's moving to St. Louis.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. Can you do a body scan on her, please? And tell her what you find.
Her elbows feel warm.
Mm-hmm. What's going on in her elbows? What do you see there?
It's dark.
Dark. Mm-hmm. Is there an influence there in her elbows?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Would you allow me to speak to it today and find out what's going on?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So I'm going to take my hands and bring it up. Bring that energy up from the elbows. Bring it up, 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 up. Good evening. Are you male or female?
Male.
Male. How long have you been there with Jackie?
When she was a kid.
When she was a kid. How old was she?
Eleven.
What was going on in her life at 11 that made her so vulnerable for you to attach to her?
She was depressed.
She was depressed. Mm-hmm.
Just taking care of her mom.
She was taking care of her mom. Okay. What may I call you? What's your name?
I don't have a name.
Can I call you Elbow?
Yeah.
Okay, Elbow. Elbow, can you recall the last time you had a life? A body? Look back in time. What do you remember about your lifetime?
Dirty.
Dirty. Tell me more.
Labor.
Mm-hmm. You did labor?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. What kind of labor?
Chimney sweep.
The chimney sweeping. Okay. What did they call you then?
Snook.
Snook, that was your name, your nickname?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And why did they call you Snook?
Because I was dirty and tight places and okay. Just stuck.
Okay. And how old are you there?
40.
40. So, Snook, I want you to think back the last day of your life and tell me how it is that you lost your body.
I choked.
You choked. How did you choke?
Dust.
Mm. And what happened after you choked? What happened to your soul? Where did you go?
Nowhere.
So how did you find Jackie?
She seemed comfy.
Mm, I see. Kind of like a chimney, huh?
Mm-hmm.
So what symptoms have you caused her?
Just feeling complacent.
Mm. not doing much with her life?
Yeah.
Why did you make her feel that way? What's the purpose of it?
So I can stay there.
Ah. But you see, Snook, that's not the normal evolution of a soul. When one leaves their body, the natural progression is for you to go to the light, go back home. Why were you afraid of going back to the light?
Didn't think I'd know anyone.
I see. So you'd rather stay here?
Yeah.
Okay. But Stuck, that's not the natural progression. How do you feel about yourself?
Bad.
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
I don't do anything.
Kind of lazy?
Yeah.
So you want her to feel lazy too, huh? Okay. Because laziness likes company, doesn't it? Snook, I'm going to ask the angels of the light to come and surround you so that you can feel their love. And tell me when you feel them.
Yeah.
How does it feel?
Nice.
Do they feel familiar? They feel loving?
Yeah.
Would you like to feel more of that? But the only way to do that is to go back home. Would you trust me and allow me to guide you back home?
Yeah.
All right. But before you do that, you've caused Jackie a lot of harm, haven't you? Making her feel so complacent, lazy. That's not very good. You've been a parasite all this time, haven't you? Would you like her to forgive you for that?
Yeah.
All right, let's speak with Jackie. Jackie, can you forgive this man for not knowing any better?
Yeah.
Making you feel lazy, complacent. What would you like to tell him?
Thanks for no thanks.
Can we send them off to the light now with love? All right, so let me speak with him. Snook, are you ready to take all of your luggage and leave?
Yeah.
All right, so go inside of her body and pull out from her elbows and anywhere else in her body where you have made your home. Tell me where it is.
Stomach.
Your stomach. Is that where you've been? So what does she see there in that stomach?
Smog.
Smog, all right. So, Jackie, I want you to go inside of that tummy and use whatever you need to get it out. What would you like to use to get that smog out? Could use any tool you want.
Vacuum.
All right, so I want you to start vacuuming all that out. And Snook, I want you to start pulling out all of your attachments from her while she's working on all of that smog. And when you're done with all of those attachments, everything that you've used to attach to her, give it to the angels. They'll take that. Jackie, tell me when you're done. How does your stomach look now?
Shiny.
Very good. So I'm going to have the angels take all that smog away. Take that vacuum. And now, Snook, I want you to go through the top of her head with the angels. Archangel Michael is there to accompany you to the light. And when you get there, I want you to tell me if there's anybody there to greet you.
My mom.
What does she tell you?
Missed you.
So all this time, Snook, you could have gone home. How do you feel now?
Better.
May the light of the universe accompany you, Snook. Thank you very much. And now take a deep breath in and let me speak with your higher self.
How does she look now? check her body and see if there's any other areas that we need to take care of today.
She looks good.
She looks good. Very good. So what I'm going to ask is for the higher self and the angels to start covering her with light. Seal all of her body with that light. Seal her aura. Align her chakras. And if there's any other entities waiting to take Snook's place, I want them to take them directly to the light. And now that she's covered in that beautiful light, raising her vibration, is there anything else that I could have asked that you would like to tell her about today?
Go for it.
Mm-hmm. Good. Is that your final message?
Just get out there and do it.
Very good. Very good. Is there any other message for anybody else that she knows?
No.
Very good. Are we complete today?
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Wide awake now, feeling wonderful all over.
Wow. Welcome back. What do you think?
Yeah.
What an experience.
Huh? I know. I guess I feel crusty.
That's okay. So, how long do you feel you were on this journey?
An hour.
It's a lot more. It's about an hour and 39 minutes.
Oh, wow.
So, how does this compare to the other experience you had?
It feels more in depth.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. For sure.
How did it feel to be with your guide?
Really nice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You could feel that every time you went back.
Yeah.
He was right there guiding you. You did a good job. So now you know that whenever you go back, it's like, oh,
yeah.
Okay, you're back.
Yeah.
Let's go back to school. You know?
Yeah, totally.
And the part when you picked out your mom and dad. They were just kids.
Yeah, they were little kids.
Isn't that wild?
Yeah.
You picked them way before.
Yeah. That is wild.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
You were doing your life review and they were still kids and you were picking them then.
Yeah.
Which means the life review is a lot more intense than we think.
Right.
Because it's seeing the future.
I know. I always imagined we would see them as adults.
You saw them as kids?
Yeah.
No, isn't that funny? I was learning something too as I saw that.
It was like I was like seeing what made them
who they are.
Them.
Yeah.
And picking that.
Your dad was kind of like, you know, just having a good time.
Yeah.
And your mom was
not. My mom was not. Yeah.
Right. So you could see where all that craziness came in.
Yeah.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And the life of Helen.
Mm.
Tough, huh?
Yeah.
Do you see where your wanting to eat fast came from?
Yes.
She was starving.
Yeah.
She didn't know when she was going to get her next meal.
Yeah. Yeah, that made a lot of sense.
So now you understand that that's not needed anymore.
Yeah.
You're not going to be losing anything. You're not going to be running out of anything.
Mm-hmm.
It all came from that horrible situation that she was in, that she didn't know where the next piece of food was going to come from.
Or who she was going to lose.
Right.
Or what.
So all that was bleeding into this life.
My God, that's crazy.
You can let it go now.
I like really felt that in my heart.
Mm-hmm. And you could see that it's like it tore your heart.
Yeah.
How does it feel now? It's good, huh?
Yeah.
Because we were able to release that before she died.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I know that this was pretty intense and a lot of stuff was pretty personal.
Mm-hmm.
So is this something that you want to share?
Oh, I would hands down share it.
You want to share it?
Yeah, because I've learned so much from other people. So,
And we could decide what parts if you want to take out.
Yeah,
you can take
for
out.
Sure.
But definitely,
yeah,
you want to share
definitely.
It.
Definitely.
Good. So let's sit up and
let's
say goodbye.
So here we are in St. Louis. Yep. We just had a really interesting session. And so now that you've experienced it, this is the second hypnosis session that you've had.
Yep.
So how does this compare?
This one was just a lot more in depth. Mm-hmm. And I've actually felt it more in my body than mm-hmm. I did the first mm-hmm. time, like the emotions and...
Well, the Helen part.
Yeah, I could feel that in my heart.
That was tough. That was tough to watch, mm-hmm. you know, because she was starving and...
Yeah.
It was really, really intense. What about the parts between lives?
That was awesome. That was just really comforting. And
to know what happens.
Yeah.
After you're gone.
It's right.
Like, oh, there he is again. It's yeah. my
guy. Yeah, and it made sense because I had that whole, like, kind of, like, lonely mm-hmm. feeling, mm-hmm. like, homesick.
Yeah.
And then it just, like, clicked when whoever this person was, I don't even know if
that's
name,
who you were. That's who you were kind
yeah.
of wanting to go back.
Yeah.
So when you were little, it's mm-hmm. like, I want to be back with him.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
Totally.
Right? Cool.
Yeah.
So, what would you like to tell the folks out there? Because you definitely wanted to share this because you've learned a lot.
Yeah.
What would you like to tell them about this experience and how they could benefit from it?
I mean, there's things you know, but you don't realize you know. Mm-hmm. And, yeah, it's just opening up, like, self-discovery and letting go of fear and... Mm-hmm. Feels awesome.
So how would you recommend they prepare for a session like this? How did you prepare?
I was meditating a lot a few weeks before. Mm-hmm. And I really, like, I wrote questions and then I rewrote questions. Because as I was writing them, I realized I knew the answers to
a lot of them. Which is your higher self.
I know.
It's already.
Anne and I were talking about that. We're like... Mm-hmm. Oh, like, it's really this easy to connect with, like,
yeah.
I realized in preparing for that. Uh-huh. But yeah, and then just telling myself that I was ready to hear whatever mm-hmm. came, mm-hmm. I would tell myself that.
Good, so. Good. Excellent. So how did it feel to be an hypnosis? That's the question everybody wants to know. What's it feel like? Did you know you were in this room?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I was present.
Yeah, which is everybody's thing. Yeah. It's like, I don't think I was hypnotized because I felt present.
Yeah, I was present, but I was just, like, so focused on what was being asked that mm-hmm. it was, like, nothing else mattered. But mm-hmm. I felt totally in control and, like, mm-hmm. I knew what was going on. So. Mm-hmm.
Well, also some of the questions that people ask is, I think her conscious mind is answering that because... taking too long to answer. Mm-hmm. What would you say about that?
I was really feeling mm-hmm. like the answer.
Yeah. So the hesitation was more like you were experiencing
it? Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Instead of your conscious mind was trying to figure out what to say.
Right. Exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That was one of the questions that we had on YouTube is, I think that the conscious mind was there. You know who you are. Who was asking that?
No, yeah. It mm-hmm. was like, I was like, it's almost like I was being shown something.
Yeah.
And
you were processing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Feeling.
Figuring kind of like how to articulate it. Because it was almost like some of this stuff like didn't even have words in a way.
Yeah.
If that makes any
sense. You were actually... receiving the information as maybe emotions and everything as then words. You mm-hmm. couldn't express what you were saying.
Right.
Good. Well, I'm glad I'm asking you these things because these are the questions that people who watch this video are asking. You know, mm-hmm. they're saying, well, you know, I don't think this is real. I don't think it's really happening. And you've just experienced it twice now mm-hmm. with me and with someone else. And you feel it's real?
Yeah, for sure.
So how do you think this will help you as a person now?
Just, I feel like I know what I have to do.
You're ready. You're ready to go out there.
I've been feeling like I've been ready. Like, I've been, like, really on the cusp of it.
Yes.
But I just feel like...
And the 555 and the 5555s are, like, happening.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah. So.
So did you travel far from this? For this?
I sort of. Four hours.
Four hours.
Chicago.
From Chicago.
Yeah.
So she came from Chicago to to St. Louis, and I came from Miami to St. Louis. So yes. We both kind of like met
in the middle.
Yeah. So if you want an experience similar to this, not exactly, but if you want your own experience, you can go to my website, albaweinman.com, like Jackie did. And was it easy?
Very easy.
Mm-hmm. So just sign up, and I do travel, as you know. I'm in St. Louis. I'll be traveling all over the country. Sign up for my newsletter so you can see where I'm going to next. Okay? So until the next time, thank you for watching. Bye. And now my favorite part.
Yes. The hug. I know.
That was awesome.
Oh, I love the hugs.
I know. It's like all the energy.
I know. We have to give each other the energy.
You feel like bonded kind of after that.
Oh, yeah. Because we're connected heart to heart. We went through the whole journey. That's why it's like at the end.
Do you kind of experience it too?
Yes. Oh, I'm there. I'm seeing it.
Really?
Well, I mean, like when you read a book, you know, so.
That one was intense. Oh, my God. The first one, I was kind of like, this is kind of, like, boring. But then it started to get kind of like,
yeah. Cool. Go get him, sister.
Cool. All right. So until the next time, bye.